What up guys, Shiroi here from Just Another Style Channel, and today I got a sneaker review for you guys. I know I haven't done one in a long time. That means I gotta go hard and show you guys one of the most exclusive sneakers if I'm gonna do a sneaker review. So without further ado, let's get a drum roll going. Let's have a look at what it is. These aren't your regular Tinker Hatfield shoes. I don't think you guys are ready for this. I don't know if you are. Hold up. Boom. You guys see that? These aren't the Cement 3s. These aren't the Free Throw 3s either. These are the Tinker Hatfield and Justin Timberlake halftime Super Bowl shoes right over here. These 3s are so exclusive. I think there's around only 5,000 pairs that were made, and I was lucky enough to be in a city where these actually launched, and your boy got a pair of these, and obviously resell is life, so your boy already sold these. So hello, that's my bank calling right there. Hello, yeah, you guys wired it through, blessed. I already sold these because the value of these sneakers is around 1,000 Canadian dollars
right here. What I call them, fun coupons. See that? A fun coupon.
And I had to cash out because your boy's trying to go on vacation and trying to do a little fun things here and there, you know. I'm trying to eat good out here, so had to flip these. But before I flip these and before I put it up, I already sold it on StockX. Shout out to StockX. But before I ship these out, I just wanted to show you guys this amazing sneaker, because not a lot of people got their hands on this shoe, except for about 350 people in Toronto. But besides that, this shoe was pretty hard and pretty exclusive to get, and I wanted to show it off on YouTube, show you guys, for all those sneakerheads out there that actually appreciate sneakers and enjoy them. And obviously, resale culture is part of it. Soft. If you're hating on me because of that, it's all good. I understand. Because, let's be real, the shoe was $300 Canadian. I sold it for $1,000. That's a big markup, like $700 markup. So, it is what it is. And yeah, so I just want to share this with you guys before I ship it out. I want to show you guys something that not a lot of people have on YouTube. And if you're a sneakerhead, you're going to appreciate this. And this one's for the culture. I got you guys. So before I even talk about the sneaker, let me talk about how I actually ended up getting it. So my boy actually messaged me and sent me a tweet, a screenshot, I think it was from Complex, and posted up on the screen over here. And it basically said, Jordan store, or 306 Yonge, which is the Toronto Jordan store, at 623 Justin Timberlake, and that was it. That's what they posted. And I was at home, and I had a class from 3 to 6, so I was like, shit, I can't line up. And I thought I was gonna be screwed over, I couldn't get it, and I was like, yo, I just lost out on a rack. And the reason I didn't skip class is because I had a presentation, and your boy is a young scholar, trying to get his GPA up, keep it at a 4.0, you already know. And it is what it is. So, after that, I was like kind of bummed out, and I was like, maybe there's only 40, 50 pairs, right? So I won't get my hands on it. But just in case, I was like, you know what, it's 1:30 now, lineup's probably getting long because the tweet's been out for like 20 minutes. So I text my brother because he's close by, and he actually responded to his phone for the first time, and he was like, I'm on my way. So he's in line now, and he's about 50th in line. I'm like, okay, chances are kind of slim. So I hit on my boy, we get the plug to tell us how many pairs are actually inside the store, and he says 200. And I'm like, geez, are we actually coming up on something over here? So my brother's lined up now, and he's there from 2, it's dropping at 6:23. We're like, all right, we're blessed, we're good. I don't know how hectic this line is gonna be, but luckily this time Jordan's store really had it under control. They were giving out wristbands, and he got his wristband on, and he was number 53. So we knew we were good. We were 53 out of like 200, and later on it became 350, and they had about 500 pairs in total, 150 for staff, I think, 350 for the public. And yeah, but either way, we were good. We had our pair on lockdown, and the first 23 actually got signed. So my class finished up around 6 o'clock. So I go and check in on my little broski. You know how it is. I have to check in on the guy that's been camping out there in the cold in the streets, really hustling for a shoe out here for me. So I was like, yo, I gotta check in on the broski. As soon as I get there, I'm walking, I see a black Escalade, everyone surrounding the black Escalade. And I'm like, yo, could the man them actually be in there? And turns out he wasn't, because as I try to look over at that black Escalade, another one pulls up right behind me, and what do you know, Justin Timberlake's right there in the front seat. I'm like, oh shit, man's actually right there. So I actually got to see him at least. Obviously, it's whatever, like ever since, think NSYNC, his prime time's been done. I ain't really messing with the music these days, it is what it is. Like back in the day, like Sexy Back, that was my jam in like middle school. So and this glow up happened. So, you know, I'm really bringing sexy back, but.
Ew, no!
Besides that and my typical F-boy shit, we got our hands on these over here. My brother did not get to meet him because he only did the first 23 pairs and then he rolled out. So apparently, if you want this shoe, all you gotta do is be in a city that he's performing his tour at, and this was the first city he did a stop at. So we were lucky enough to get 500. I think every city is doing that. He's re-releasing some of these shoes and putting it out there. So now this is where the part of the story where the guap comes in. So everyone out there is a young reseller trying to do their thing. So the thing was, if you were earlier on in line, you could go on StockX and sell yours right away and get the highest ask price. So that's what I did. I was literally waiting outside for my brother, texting him. I'm like, yo, when's your turn to go in? As soon as he went in, I looked at which was the highest size, which is the highest profit margin. And I was like, all right, I need you to pick up a 9.5. So he comes out with a 9.5. As soon as he has it in hand, I pressed ask, done. Sell right away, sold it right there on the spot. Came up to around 1,000 Canadian after conversion and fees and all that good stuff. And obviously I had to sauce the broski most of the money because, you know, he's the one who was really out there in the trenches doing his thing with the young resellers, with the hype beasts, with the mans and bread toes. And I'm out here wearing Tim's and a Root sweater and he's out there just wearing an Abercrombie jacket doing his thing. Honestly, you don't gotta flex in line. Real ones know if you're really making money moves out there, you could be in sweatpants doing your thing. It doesn't make a difference. But we came up on this pair here. Honestly, I could have lined up probably and still got one, but by then resale prices dropped. And time value appreciation, like I could have made some money. I'm not saying I couldn't have, but it wasn't worth it. There was a lot of other things to get done in that day. And honestly, I'm grateful to have one pair secure it. If someone else out there in the city wanted to get a pair, then whatever, they could have lined up and that would have been my spot maybe, but that's theirs, you know, and that's what it was. And we got these shoes over here. Alright, so I think I've done enough talking, so let's get some close-ups of this shoe so you guys can appreciate it for what it is. And yeah, let's get into it right away. Let's look at some close-ups.
In awe, in thrilling, new, living sound. Kill me with that coochie, 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 coochie. She kill me with that coochie, 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 coochie. She kill me with that coochie, 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 coochie. She kill me with that coochie.
Training to get the gold. That's why your body's crazy. But you can't run from yourself. That's where it's difficult. Girl, I can see in your eyes that there's something inside that made you evolve. Where did you go? Cause it just ain't fair. Over here thinking about the shit you say. Don't know why it gets to me.
It cuts right on my eye. Yeah, hurt, won't lie. Still can't see.
All right, so now that you guys got to see some close-ups and my young Steven Spielberg on that type of ish right now, you know, doing that directing, look at those close-up shots, so clean. And it's honestly because I have such an amazing, beautiful model to work with over here.
Oh, you're wicked. You got your mojo working overtime.
These shoes are just, I don't know what I love about it more, the fact that this paid off like almost all my tuition in one shot, or the fact that I just got to hold on to something for a little bit of time that's a very exclusive shoe. I don't think I've ever come up on anything this good before, and it honestly is such a great feeling to have. But yeah, let's actually talk about the shoe for a second. So you obviously got the Nike Air on the back, and I like the fact that they put the Nike Air instead of the Jordan logo on it. It's great to see that this is actually being brought back on all the sneakers. It's a piece of history that's being brought back instead of just the Jordan Band logo, and I appreciate that about it. I might not appreciate the markup, but it is what it is. You give and take. You got the Jordan branding in the front and the subtle detailing like the Tinker Hatfield signature on the inside. That was honestly a really good touch. Obviously Tinker Hatfield signature on the tag as well with the Jordan branding logo. The tumble leather on this is just impeccable. It is fuego. The elephant print is perfect. The stitching, everything on this shoe is amazing. And one of the great things about this shoe is that it's subtle. Like the Nike check is so subtle. You wouldn't notice it. It's white on white. That's what I like about this one the most. And I'm actually gonna show you guys here. I'm gonna open up Snapchat, cause who really uses Snapchat these days except me? Cause I think everyone hopped off of that, but let's see, hold on. Let me see if it picks up in the video. I don't think it's gonna pick up. Hold on, let me show you guys on my phone. Look at that. Look at that. It's that 3M right there. Amazing. That's such a subtle detail that you probably wouldn't notice about the shoe, but when the light shines on it, boom, you're flashing, you're stunning. It's a subtle flex. I love it. And it's such a great touch that they added instead of just a white tumble leather on there or just a regular white swoosh. And it's the little things like that that I really appreciate about it. The stitching on the Nike over here on the inside is actually really nicely done as well. There's no loose threads. It's perfectly done up. And overall, this is such a clean shoe. But the thing is, sometimes you have to value things in a different way. Sometimes you gotta value, do you appreciate it because of the money value or aspect to it, or do you actually wanna rock it? Like with bread toes and things like that, I do own a pair of bread toes and I want those in my collection. Royals, even the shadows that are coming out, I'm gonna keep those because those mean more to me. Threes weren't really my thing, and maybe later on, like, it'll grow on me. The black cement threes were amazing, but $300 price tag wasn't amazing to me. And when I'm holding something that really is one third my tuition, or I know even after giving my brother some money, I could help him pay for his vacation that's coming up, pay for some of my thing, and still, like, keep everyone happy, you know? Like, I'm not gonna appreciate the shoe as a next guy, and that's why on StockX, I put it up there. I took the highest ask price. I was fortunate enough that the person was willing to pay that much. And the beautiful thing about StockX is the fact that there's a buyer out there that really is willing to pay that much for the shoe. Obviously, feel bad for the guy now because price has actually dropped, I think, 100 to 200 more, but it's whatever, you know? That person was actually willing to pay this price to own the shoe, and they got it. I got the money. Everyone's happy. It's a win-win situation for everyone out there. All right, so that concludes the video, and honestly, thank you guys for watching. I really appreciate it. I hope you guys enjoyed this sneaker unboxing slash review. It's not really an unboxing, it's more of a review, but hope you guys enjoy it because I haven't done one of these in such a long time. I truly enjoy these. This is why I actually started the channel. More than streetwear, I was into fashion as well, but I was into sneakers as well. And looking at sneakers and holding things, I never had the means to actually get all this stuff or the capital. And when I got a part-time job, I was able to pay for things on my own and actually get shoes that I like or I've grown up seeing and seen on TV, seen on MTV, seen on all the celebrities I love and things like that. And just being able to hold a part of that culture is amazing to see. And although that halftime Super Bowl performance wasn't the best in history, they did make history with these over here. One of the most subtly executed branding ever done by Nike. It was like literally free advertisement. It wasn't free because they obviously planned this out, but it was like an organic thing. It really just happened on its own, and the shoe took off on its own and had its own history behind it more than the Super Bowl performance itself. So that's one of the great reasons I'm happy I got to hold a shoe. I got to hold a piece of culture over here, a piece of history. And I also got to hold on to a little more money in my bank account. Always gotta mention that, because you know what? I gotta keep it 100 with you guys. Like, if I'm keeping a shoe, I'll be honest. Like, I could tell you a shoe is worth a rack, but I'm gonna hold on to it, I'm gonna wear it, I'm gonna beat to the ground, because I could be like, that's part of the culture. But there's also that little bit of resale culture in me that will always want to sell a shoe and realize that there's other things out there that I can get with that type of money, or I can pay with that type of money, and I can be a little happier with that type of money more than just wearing the shoe. Knowing that I just creased up $1,000 would hurt. Like, yo, that's, I can't even fathom that right now. The fact I use the word fathom should really tell you guys how much, yeah, you should see my priorities lie with this shoe over here. Anyways, guys, hold up, before we even leave, pose up for that thumbnail. Hello. All right, so with that being said, make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and subscribe to my Spotify playlist, which is It's a Vibe. It's down in the description down below. Link is all over there. Like, comment, subscribe. We're getting closer to 1,000 day by day. To all you 1-2 new subscribers that like this video and join my channel every day, see my content, I really appreciate you. Welcome to the family. It's a small one, but it's growing slowly but surely. And I do appreciate that. You guys mean the world to me. This is a passion to me. I will always keep putting out videos. I will always resell in order to make new content, and that's how I keep that money flow going. I have to move things to buy new things. It is what it is. So all the money that I make, I do invest back into this channel and back into you guys, because that's really what I'm investing into. I'm investing into you guys. I'm investing into the content so I can exchange your time for my content that you guys hopefully enjoy out there. And with that being said, without getting too touchy-feely, I will see you guys next time.